Hallelujah, praise the living God. So I've been studying up on Saul in the book of Acts chapter 9. I've been reading about Saul before he became a new man with a new name, Paul. And something I realized is that when Saul was on his way to Damascus to persecute the church, while he was on his way there, the Bible says that Jesus, he knocked him off of his high horse. He knocked him to the ground and he blinded him for 3 days. And when he did this, the Bible says that while Saul was on the ground, he said, "Who are you, Lord?" He said, "What do you want me to do?" And Jesus said, "I'm Jesus who you persecute. It's hard for you to kick against the pricks." And something I realized is that before God is willing to use us and take us to another level in the anointing of him, in order for God to use us, he got to get that pride out of us first. He got to knock us off our high horse first. He got to get us to a place where we humble ourselves so he can use us, so he can anoint us in the way that he greatly desired to do. And see, when Saul had humbled himself, he was blinded for 3 days. And the Bible says while he was blind, he didn't eat nothing. He was fasting. And he came to a place of brokenness. God had to rip him from his pride. And Saul received the new name, Paul, Apostle Paul. And he became one of the greatest apostles ever lived. If you read throughout the New Testament, that was the Apostle Paul preaching. You know, so it showed me that God want to rip us from our pride so he can use us the way he want to. He got to knock us off our high horse sometimes because we get so lifted up in pride and spiritual pride to where God can't use us, because he said he resists the proud, but he give grace to who? To the humble. And so God has to knock us off our high horse sometimes. So sometimes the trials that we facing in our lives, it could be God that's knocking us off our high horse. Some of the things that we're going through in our life, it could be God knocking us off our high horse and trying to open our eyes up because we are blind. And I wanted to share this because this is something that I really seen when I was reading this. Before God can use us the way that he greatly desired, he got to knock us off our high horse and get that pride out of us. And that's the only way we'll receive that new name, become a new person. God has to knock us off our high horse first. And then he will give us a new name. And then he will use us for his glory. Then he will pour his anointing out on us. Some of the people that you see preaching the gospel, doing things for God, God haven't anointed them. God haven't sent them to preach the gospel because they haven't been knocked off that high horse yet. That's why you got people that's preaching out of pride, preaching out of strife, preaching out of envy. They haven't been knocked off that high horse yet. And I'm here to tell you that God will knock you off of your high horse to get that pride out of you so that other people can be saved, so he can pour his love inside of you. Because notice, when Paul got up and went into the town, he was a new man. He had the love. He didn't persecute the people. His mission was to go to Damascus to kill the Christians, to bring them back to Jerusalem. Bam! But instead, he had that love inside of him. Jesus poured his love inside of him. And he started loving his brothers and sisters in Christ and started preaching the gospel all throughout the world. And people started getting saved. People started giving their life to the Lord. We started seeing the manifestation of salvation through the Apostle Paul when God knocked him off of his high horse and got that pride out of him. So if you want God to use you, my friend, God's going to have to knock you off that high horse first and get that pride out of you. Be blessed.